Good morning, students. Today I am continuing with the chapter number 7, and the name of the chapter is Congruence of Triangle, one of the interesting chapter from maths. So first we will continue with the word congruency or congruence. So what is the meaning of that? So congruency means we can say two figures are congruent or congruence if they have exactly the same shape and size. As you see here, these are two duster. Okay, if we will put one duster in such a way and second duster just behind of it, so we can say this is the first object and this is the second one. So both are the exact copy of each other. If we will put in such a way, so we can say this is the case of congruency or this is the case of superimpose. So at present you see only the first part of this duster, or this is not seen by you. Same for the other. These are two chalks, same shape, same size. If I put one chalk in such a way, so this is the case of congruency or this is the case of superimpose. We can say, same example, these two rectangle shapes are there, we can say. So some points are there, A, B, C, D, and this is your E, F, G, H. If I put one shape on the other, it looks like this. So again, this is the case of superimpose, or we can say superposition. Okay, so first we will continue with the introduction part of this chapter. So what is the meaning of congruence? The meaning of congruence is superimpose, or we can say superposition, right? In our daily routine, there are so many examples. We can say two keys of same lock, right? And if you are taking two notes of same denomination, these are some examples related with the word congruency. Basically, it is the exact copy of the another object, which is known as superimpose or superposition. So we can say two figures are congruent if they have exactly the same shape and size. So first I will continue with the word congruence of plane figures. So when we say two plane figures are congruent or congruent, I am making here some diagram. This is F1. This is F2 diagram. We can say F1 is congruent to F2. This is the symbol of congruency. So in congruence of plane figures, in this concept we can see if one figure is congruent to another figure, or F1 is congruent to F2, if they have exactly same shape and size, and it can be written as F1 is congruent to F2, and we are using this symbol related with the congruency. Now I am continuing with the next concept, that is related with congruence of angles. So again we will continue with some figures related with this word congruence. With the help of this diagram, we will easily say which angles are congruent to each other. So the next concept is congruence of angles. So I am making here some figures related with angles. This is angle A, B, C, and the measurement of ABC is 40 degree. This is the first figure. I am continuing with the second figure. This is P, Q, R. Again, it is related with 40 degree. This is the second figure. I am continuing with the third figure. S, Y, Z. This is 30 degree. It is the third figure. And the fourth one is, if I am saying this is L, M, N related with 40 degrees.
So how can we say on behalf of these diagrams कि which angle is congruent to which one? So figure first, second and third. All these are congruent because their measurement of angles are equal. In this category we will not include the third one because in third figure the measurement of angle is 30 degrees. That's why we can say angle ABC is congruent to angle PQR, which is also congruent to angle L, M or N, because all in these angles the measurement of the angle is same. That's why they are congruent. So this is the concept of congruence of angles. After this concept, I am continuing with one very important concept, that is congruency of triangles. This is very very important concept related with corresponding sides, vertices and angles. So now we continue with the word congruence of triangles. So again I am continuing with some diagram. This is triangle ABC. On the same time I am taking one more triangle, that is PQR. Now we will come to the word correspondence, which is very very important. So we can say A is correspondence to vertices P, B is correspondence to point Q and C is correspondence to point R. So how can we will represent corresponding sides? Corresponding sides in these two triangles ABC and PQR, we can say AB side is corresponding to PQ side, and it can be written as AB side corresponding to PQ. So this is the symbol related with correspondence. After this we can say BC side and QR side is corresponding of each other, so we can see it can be written as BC correspondent to QR. Now we come to the next side, that is CA. CA side is corresponding to RP side and it can be written as CA corresponding to RP. So this is the concept of corresponding sides. After corresponding sides, I am continuing with corresponding vertices. So we can say A and T both are corresponding vertices and it can be written as A corresponding to P, and B and Q both are corresponding vertices of each other and it can be written as B is corresponding to Q. After that C and R both are corresponding vertices of each other, so that it can be written as C is corresponding to R. So after corresponding vertices we will continue with corresponding angles. So in these two triangles angle A is corresponding to angle P, angle B is corresponding to angle Q and angle C is corresponding to angle R. So we can say angle A and angle P both are corresponding angle of each other and it can be written as angle A is corresponding to angle P. After this we can say angle B and angle Q both are corresponding to each other, so that it can be written as angle B corresponding to angle Q. After this angle C and angle R both are corresponding to each other, so that it can be written as angle C is corresponding to angle R. So after getting corresponding sides, corresponding vertices and corresponding angles, we can say triangle ABC is congruent to A is related with P, so first we will write P. B is related with Q, so we will write Q. C is related with R, so we will write R. It means we can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. If we come to on the point correspondence, then we can say ABC is correspondence to PQR. So this is the concept related with congruence of triangles. Basically, congruence of triangles include one of the important concept, that is the corresponding or correspondence. With the help of correspondence, with the help of the arrow mark, we will easily identify yes which vertices is related with another vertices of other triangle. So on behalf of corresponding sides, corresponding vertices and corresponding angles, we can say these two triangles are congruent, or we can say ABC is congruent to PQR. After this, I am continuing with one question. With the help of this question, the concept of congruence of triangles and correspondence is clear to all of you. So, after this, I will write one question so that this concept is more clear. There are two exercises given in this chapter, 7.1 and 7.2. So we will solve 7.1 with the help of all these things, that is congruence of triangles, corresponding word. So I am continuing with one example. So first I am writing here one question. The question is triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent under the correspondence ABC correspondence to RQP. Write the parts of triangle ABC that correspond to, the first part is PQ, second part is Q, and the third part is, second part is angle Q, and the third part is RP. So, how can we give the answer of this question with the help of congruence of triangle or with the help of correspondence? So, first we will continue with two diagrams or two triangles ABC and one more triangle PQR. So, we can say here A is correspondence to R, and after this we can say C is correspondence to P and B is correspondence to Q, right? It is written here also, A is correspondence to R, B is correspondence to Q, and C is correspondence to P. With the help of this we will easily identify yes which vertices is related to the which vertices of another triangle. So how can we give the answer? The first part is PQ line segment. We can say if we are taking here PQ, it means P is related with C. So we will write here C first, and Q is related with B. So we will write here CB. It means PQ line segment is related with CB line segment. Second one, angle Q. So angle Q, it means this angle. Angle Q is correspondence to angle B. So we write here angle B. The third part is line segment RP. So R is correspondence to A. So we write here A.
and C is correspondence to C, we will write here C. So with the help of correspondence or with the help of this diagram, which includes the concept of correspondence, we will give the answer of this question very easily. So again, I want to tell that A is related with R, B is A is related with R, B is related with Q, and C is related with P. So with the help of this corresponding concept, we will easily explain the answer of such type of the question. I am continuing with the next concept, and the next concept is criteria of congruence of triangles. So under this heading, when we can say two triangles are congruent, so we will go with four steps, that is SSS, criterion of congruency. Second one is side angle side, criterion of congruency. Third one is angle side angle, criterion of congruency, and the last one is RHS, criterion of congruency. On behalf of these four, we can say two triangles are congruent or not. So first I am continuing with the SSS criterion of congruency. So it will be more clear if I am taking one example here, so that or with the help of one diagram it will be more clear. So this is triangle ABC. The measurement of AB is 1.5 cm, this is 2.5 cm, and this is 2.2 cm, and here I am taking P, Q, R. The measurement of PQ is 1.5 cm, here it is 2.5 cm and 2.2 cm. So basically we continue with the SSS criterion, it means side, side and side. So how can we apply this concept on these two triangles? Okay. So we have to show the congruency. So with the help of correspondence, we can say these two triangles will be congruent if the three sides of this first triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of this second triangle. Then they will congruent, otherwise congruency not possible. So first we will go with the correspondence. So A is corresponding to P, B is corresponding to Q, and C is corresponding to R. It means we can say side AB is equal to side PQ, because both have equal length, that is 1.5 cm. After that we will come here BC. BC side of the first triangle is equivalent to QR side of the second triangle. So we will write here BC side is equal to QR side because their length are same, which is equivalent to 2.5 cm. Now we will come to the third side, that is CA. So we can say CA side is equal to RP side because their length is 2.2 cm. So it is related with side, this is also related with side, it is also related with side. So we can say by SSS or SSS criterion of congruency, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle A is related with P, so first we will write P, B is related with Q, so we will write Q, and C is related with R, we will write here R. So we can say these two triangles are congruent with the help of SSS criterion of congruency. With the help of same, we will continue with our second, third and fourth criterion of congruency. So after this, I am continuing with the second one. And the second one is SAS criterion. So again, I will make two triangles, because SAS means side angle side, two sides and one angle. So how can we will show the congruency between two triangles? So first I will make that diagram, after that I will show to you this concept. So diagrams are, this is the first triangle A, B, C with angle 35 degree and the measurement is 2.5 centimeter, and the second triangle is R, P, Q. In this triangle, this angle P is 35 degree and here measurement is 3 centimeter and this is 2.5 centimeter, because we have to take two sides and one angle. So these are two sides and one angle. So how can we will apply this concept here? Okay, so first again we will go with the word correspondence, which is very very important. So we can say A is corresponding to vertices R in the another triangle. Okay, 35 degree is related with C in this triangle ACB. So we can say, or we can say C is related with vertices P, right? Because this is 35 degree and this is also 35 degree. After that we will come to a point B. B is correspondence to this Q. Okay, so how can we show the congruence in these two triangles? So first we will come side and the side. So first we will take side. So if I am taking side AC from the first triangle, so we can say AC is related with RP. So we will write here AC equals to RP, because the both the measurements are equal, that is 2.5 centimeter. After this I will come on angle. So in first triangle we will take angle C, which is equivalent to angle P, because both have equal measure, this is equal to 35 degree. After angle, again we will come to on side. So we will take this side. If I am taking CB from the first triangle, this is the first one, this is the first triangle, this is the second triangle. So if I am taking CB from the first triangle, it means from here I will take P to Q with the help of the word correspondence. That is very very important. So this is equal to 3 centimeter. So by side angle side, by side angle side criterion of congruency, we can say triangle ACB is congruent to, as you see in the figure, A is related with R, C is related with P and B is related with Q. So we can say these two triangles are congruent with the help of side angle side criterion of congruency. So corresponding word is very important. If corresponding word is you can say understood by you, then you will easily solve the question which is based on criterion of congruency. Now I am continuing with the next concept, that is related with angle side angle. So again what I will do, again I will continue with some diagram related with the triangle, and this time we will take two angles and one side, because we have to show the congruency between two angles and sides. So we can say, what is the meaning of ASA? This is the third one. So we can say two triangles are congruent if two angles, because we are using here two angles, if two angles and one side
of that particular triangle is corresponding to the another two angles and one side of another triangle, then these two triangles are congruent, otherwise it is not possible. So I am continuing with again one diagram. So this is the first triangle A B C. It is related with 40 degree, 60 degree, two angles and one side. So I will take a measurement 3.5 centimeter here. It is the first one. And the second one, different triangles I am taking here so that the concept of this congruency is clear to all of you. This time, this angle is 60 degree. This is 40 degree. This is the second triangle. And the measurement is here 3.5 centimeter. And here I am taking D, E, F. So how can we say the triangle first is congruent to triangle second? And this time we are continuing with two angle and one side. We have to show two angles of this triangle is equal to two angles of this second triangle with one side. So how can we show it? So again first we will continue with the correspondence. So C is correspondence to D. Angle B is related with 60 degree, it means angle B is correspondence to point, or B point is correspondence to F, and A point is correspondence to, you can say, E. Okay. So how can you show the congruency? We can say in triangle ABC and triangle number A is related with E, so first we will take E, B is related with 60 degree, so we will take here F, and C is related with D. So we have to show the congruency in these two triangles. So how can we show the congruency? So first I will take angle. So we can say angle A is equivalent to angle E, both are equivalent to 40 degree, right? After angle, we have to come to another point, S, this is side. So we can say side AB is equivalent to EF, and both are equal measure, that is 3.5 centimeter. Then again we will come to on another angle, we can say angle B is equivalent to angle E, both are, angle B is equivalent to angle F, not E. Okay, angle B is equivalent to angle F, both are equivalent to 60 degree. So with the help of angle, side and angle, we can say by angle, side, angle, criterion of congruency triangle ABC is congruent to triangle EFD. It means we can say under a given correspondence, two angles and the side included between them are equal to the corresponding two angles and one sides of another triangle. Then we can say triangles are congruent, otherwise it is not possible. Now I will continue with the last one, that is your RHS, criterion of congruency. So again I will make two triangles and we will continue with this criterion. So the concept of congruency is very interesting concept. You have to continue with the correspondence word. If correspondence word is clear, then you will easily show the congruency between any two triangles. So with the help of this, again I am continuing with the word correspondence. So what is the meaning of RHS? So R means right angle triangle, H means hypotenuse, and S means side. So again I am taking two diagrams here. With the help of this diagram, the concept of this diagram is clear to all of you. So here I am taking A, B, C, D and E. This side we can say it equal to BC, and these two angles are related with 90 degree. So how can we show the congruency here? So angle A is correspondence to angle C, right? After this we can say A to E and double marker is there, then C to B double marker is there, that's why we can say E is related with B, or B is correspondence to or related to D. Okay, this is the concept of correspondence. With the help of this work we have to show the congruency of RHS. So first we will take the triangle BAE and triangle. So B is related with D, it means first we will write D. A is related with C, then we will write C, and E is related with B, then we will write B. It means we have to show the congruency in these two triangles. So first I will take right angle triangle. So angle A is equivalent to angle C because both are equivalent to 90 degree, that is right angle triangle. Then we come to on hypotenuse. Hypotenuse means the side which is opposite to 90 degree. So if I am taking side EB from the first triangle, okay, so its corresponding side in the another triangle second is E is related with B, because the correspondence of E is B and B is related with D. So we can say these two sides are equal, and one marker is also given here. With the help of this we can say E, E B side is related with B B side. Again we will come to on side. So this time I am taking AE. AE side is related with side CB. AE double marker is there. AE side is related with CB. So this is your right angle triangle. This is hypotenuse side and this is the another side. So we can say by RHS criterion of congruency, these two triangle BAE is congruent to triangle DCB. So if the concept of correspondence is clear, then we will easily show the congruency of these four types of criterion. Now with the help of these criterion, I am continuing with one or two questions related with your NCERT book. So there are so many questions given in the NCERT book related with congruency. So with the help of all these concepts, we solve the questions which are related with congruency, or you can say which are related with the correspondence. So I am taking one or two questions. So at present I am taking one question from exercise 7.2. And question number 10. Again diagram is given here. So diagram is, this is A, B, C, double marker is there, and this is the triangle D, E, F, again double marker is there, this type of sign is given, and this is 90 degree, and we have to explain why triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED. So we have to show the congruency in these two triangles. So it is given here, it means A is corresponding to F B is corresponding to E and C is corresponding to D. So same thing we will continue this diagram. The A is corresponding to F. It means A is corresponding to F. Right. And B is corresponding to E. B is 90 degree and E is also 90 degree. So this is the corresponding to B. So remaining is C. So definitely C is related with B. Right. Now we have to show the congruency. So how can we show the congruency? We can say angle B and angle E both are related with 90 degree. So both the angles are equal. After that we can say angle BAC of this first triangle is equivalent to angle B is related with F. So first we will take F. A is related with F and B is related with E. So put like E, A is related with F and C is related with D. So we can say angle BAC is related with EFD. Or if you want to write directly, then answer it is possible angle A is related with angle F. Both are correct. After this, so angle B is related with angle E, angle A is related with angle F. Now we will come to one side, BC sides. So we can say BC side is related with, B is related with E. So first we will come to one E and then we will write B. It means BC side is related with AD side as per the given diagram. So which type of congruency we will use here? We can say, so by angle side, so we can say by angle side angle, criterion of congruency, these two triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED. So this is the way of solving the question which is related with correspondence or congruency. So I hope with the help of criterion of congruency and the correspondence, you will complete the remaining question which is given in your NCERT book in exercise 7.1 and 7.2. Thank you very much.